Hello from Canada. It's Jen, Denise, Scott here again. Now, this is a scene I've been working on for a few months. Obviously, it's underwater. I won't be talking as much through this one because I've got to concentrate a little bit. But I will show you this. Everything that I'm teaching you in these videos that are upcoming will give you all the techniques you need to do a whole piece. So, if you just keep watching them all, you will be able to do something like this as well. So what I'm doing is building up this coral at the moment. And what I've used on that is some moulding paste. Viatilia again. And a palette knife. And I've just dipped it into the moulding paste and just like that. It gets tacky and it gives you texture then to build your layers of colour on. So I'm trying to get different, I love how this is working, so I want to get the balance of colour going here and build up the coral. And I'm just so nearly close to finishing. Challenge myself, I have a week to finish it. Tips of the coral. Gotta try and work with the light in the center as well so that it reflects in the right places. So many layers on this coral. I could even wash on this tissue. We'll go back to the brush. What do you reckon? So if you're not sure what to do with a section of your painting, just leave it to last. I've had this here for a while, and I was standing outside the other night. I thought, oh, I could make that into a jellyfish, which I will. Okay. her here. Yep. Okay, this is Atelier Free Flow. That's what I'm using. I've already thinned that down in the tube. So where am I? Yeah. Look at how red that is. To wipe some off. The yellow's not quite dry, I'll just stay away from that. So I don't want it to blend. To wait till each layer dries before I come along with another one. That's pretty good. So, no, this is dry. Up that texture underneath. Come back after that's dry. I'll come back again with yellow. And back again with magenta. Just give that some form. Less is more in this situation. What that red did I use? Permanent alizarin. Alizarin. Use the same brush. I need some watering down. Let's try this one. to leave that green. I want it all to be the same. Walk away and make a coffee if you like. I'll be here dabbling away for a while. See any live chat, but if I'll have a look later, and if anybody's asked me any questions, I'll post it down below later today. Like I said, if you would like to challenge me in anything, I'm up for a challenge. Whether it be colour, product, technique. So just a very, very light touch. Size of the brush. Love the crows, eh? Make good pets. We used to have a pet crow when we grew up called JC. He used to chase me everywhere. Probably because I ran. If I didn't run, he probably wouldn't have chased me. Just run for the trampoline, jump up. It's him on my tail. Always had lots of animals at home living in the bush. I remember having a koala that Dad had saved in the hallway overnight. Oh, I was very young. But I do remember the mess the next morning. Animals in Mum's bed in her electric blanket. I always remember baby birds. She'd mix up mince, egg, and bread, and she would feed them. She didn't regurgitate it, she just put it in. They loved it. say we go to church? See how that magenta is really coming alive now? I just had an idea. To get the tentacles, the little stringy bits on the jellyfish, I wonder if I could do the texture. Too similar to the coral. Don't want it all looking the same. I love it. I'll take you in for a closer look towards the end. Now leave that. Leave the greeny bits. Just don't make everything the same. Has anybody noticed any animals in this painting? Like I said, I like to keep them in their habitat. They're really hard to find. Then I may, if it's not too much, maybe have some little fish swimming in and out the coral. We'll see. Love that colour. Leave that colour and just come over the top. Nice shimmers of colour coming through. It's getting a bit hot. Always take the time to stand back. Stand back. Squint your eyes, see if there's anything out of place. Is anything not sitting right? Just got to create that depth. I've got most of everything I need there, just got to get that depth. Like these darker areas in to bring out the coral. That I'm using Prussian blue hue. We'll see you. So that's it there. Don't look at my messy palette. Lightly build up layers. Less is more, remember. sure what to do with that yet. If you're not sure, like I said, leave it. From experience, I have worked and worked and worked in the past just to fix one area. But it wasn't that one area that was the problem. That one area was fine. It was the something around it that just needed tweaking that just made it all pop. And you thought it was that part because that's the part that your eye went to first. But that's because it was in place, whereas everything else needed work. I love big campuses because you need work around. You don't really have to wait for things to dry because there's always another part you can work on.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Coming along. Holding it flat to try and just get those raised edges. Can't have the light without the dark. Actually got a bit of sandpaper onto that just to show somebody that you can just come back and sandpaper it and dries, we'll come back with the yellow. Might be as dark because we're heading into the light now. Barely any paint on here. Just enough to add a bit of shading. got around the edges of this canvas, I've got painter's tape, which you get from the painting section in the hardware. Just helps to keep the edges clean, and then you can just tear it off when you're finished. Darker there. That'll make his little stringy bits stand out a bit more. String bits aren't on there yet, don't worry. You're not going mad. That's my job. I had a class this morning. Cat, a dog seemed to be worn out. I'm not down here. Sorry. after a French artist. Yes. Thing about a big painting, again, you get tired of one technique, just work on to something else quickly, have a break from that. Tired after today. Just do this. Doesn't work out. Spin over it. Texture's kind of getting in the way. Interesting. Here's some leftover two-pack. Drop some ink into it. Let it run. Funny thing was, the person using it before me, I was just using the leftovers. By the time he brought it into me, there was steam coming out of the cup. I'm trying to work with it as fast as I can, and as I'm mixing it, it's sort of set. But I've got the other four colours, five colours, but yeah. Missed that one. It's hard. It's really hot too. think you nearly finished. There's more you look, the more you find. Still gotta do all these. With my red brush. I have a different pot for each colour. That way my colours aren't going to be contaminated. How many times have you dipped in your coffee and drank your paint water? I think everybody's done it. We got yellow. Break before young Nick comes after school. Let me know if you want to see me finish this off or keep posting them. If you want it being posted, I'm happy to. Starting to pop. Something. If I had the channel up on my tablet, I could probably see the live chat on my tablet. I'll do that next time, guys. Everybody's like, no, don't sing. Well, my kids do anyway. How's that looking from your angle?
Yes, the depth is coming. I'm really happy with the way that
that's coming up. Anybody in Toowoomba needs any computer work done? My son-in-law is a computer genius. He can make it faster, put new hard drives in, you know, all that computer jargon stuff. You just message me and I'll send you the send you his number or get him in contact with you. Used to having no music when I paint. Because my brush goes to the beat. And if there's a fast beat that comes on, I have to go over to an area that needs a fast stroke. Okay. Okay. Thing about blazers, if you go outside the line, look at that, does it really matter, does it? Phone's still going, yes. It's a pretty good one back there. This, my brush is so flat that my knuckle is nearly touching the canvas. Turn the brush around. Just love that iridescent effect that you get. All these different glazes. I was trying to build a peaceful scene, but that's sort of, I'm going to turn this canvas around. Sort of off in the distance there. This was my first play with the resin, which I wish I hadn't put it on, but I can work with it. Oops. There's still a lot of areas like this, this. I love the way that's going. The paint was just sort of poured on there, very watery. I did that after this and this, so to work in behind. I'm not sure about this. Bring that down. Then take it back. Push it back. Yeah. Pushing back, pulling forward. a bigger brush. It's all bland over there. You can have a bit more control with the smaller one too. So the follow-up to this will be titled the same. But it'll be too B, because this will be 2A. It's a lot easier to do a live stream. You don't have to go and then I don't really have the storage on my phone to do videos. I'm still waiting for my camera, so video camera over there. I don't like that, it's a bit too green. I have to get some more white over that area. Going for 53 minutes, guys. Remember, if you subscribe and follow, you should get a message every time I go live. On Saturday at 10, or just after, I've got some special guests coming. So please, you can tune in. What I plan on doing. Like I've got some young boys coming, and they can come and do their class, and mum and dad can watch them from home if I live stream. So, you know, the whole family, their family's over in New Zealand, so everybody can tune in and watch the boys do their painting, and we'll just do the, we'll be doing the drag and the chain. They'll like that, something fun and simple. So you can see the technique with the drag, you know, it's come in into this painting. That was a dirty paw. Dragged through the chain, but needs a bit of love and care. Don't want it to be muddy, hey? Getting tired. You've got to know when to stop, otherwise you don't want to come out in the morning and go, oh, mistakes in art, right? Take some off. Yes. So we've got red. Red. We need it down here. Alright, guys. I might finish up because obviously I'm getting tired. So do tune in on Saturday, hey. These boys are so cute. Seven boys in the family, and one girl at the top. I'll turn this around. So well, when I put the hangers on the back, I'll be doing it both ways, this way and that way. So people, you know, it doesn't matter which way this painting goes. This coral. Okay, I'll take you down, take you for a look around, and I'll take you over to the desk there and show you what my clever people did today. Oh, come on. Ow.
Don't tell me it stopped.
Okay. My mess. I love that's on wheels. Very portable. So, hope you don't mind, Jen. That's what Jenny did. Masterpiece. And this was the leftovers, and I added red, and that was Margaret's first play with it. She was very inspired. Look at that. Blue, can't even talk now, free flow with the Atelier acrylic turquoise looks great. Absolutely magnificent. Oh, thank you, Miss Jerrica Gold. It's very sweet. If you like it, Jerrica Gold, and you live in Toowoomba, would you like to come and do a live stream with me? Okay, end.